Hello, welcome to Edupedia World. From this episode, we are going to look at some important characteristics that need to make ensuring softwares. First of all, let's see how software plays a great role in IT industry compared to the hardware with some statistical graphs. This graph depicts how software and hardware costs gradually change by time. In the earlier days, producing hardware gadgets was a complex job. Only few experts were there, and expert knowledge dissemination was so poor. Resources were so much expensive and not widely accessible. Hardware manufacturing was dominated by certain big-shot organizations. Developing software was strongly correlated to the hardware manufacturing. Most often, it was considered as a part of work of the manufacturing organizations. So those days, developing hardware which have high processing power and less physical space and high storage power with less cost was the main focus rather than developing software. In this graph, the sudden drop in the beginning of the hardware curve depicts that they have achieved it. Okay, now to make more sense on this hardware curve, I'll ask you a few questions. Question number 1. What was the physical size of the world's first electronic computer, ENIAC? What was its durability and how much operations could it handle? Could you answer them? Just Google and find the answer after watching this video. Question number 2. Have you ever used or seen a floppy disk? What were the capacity ranges it had? If you were too small those days, never mind ask from your previous generation. Question number 3. Decades ago, thus ordinary people able to afford a 16GB pen drive? Were 16GB pen drives ever existed decades ago? And finally, what capacity is the pen drive you have now? Great! Now you know prices of hardware are getting lower and lower day by day. Manufacturers getting in to know how to make them cost effectively. But for software, prices are getting higher and higher because of the people who make them, the software engineers. Cost of the software increases day by day due to the cost of affording software engineers. Not like earlier days, nowadays software development is independent from hardware manufacturing. So, software plays a great role as same as hardware presently. That's why software engineers request high salary scales as the hardware engineers. On the other hand, developing software is not a one-man job. It's a teamwork, spans along months or years depending on the changing requirements. So, by adding up human resource cost and other utility cost, the cost of software is much higher than the hardware and continues to be increased. Failure rate is another factor which affects the cost curves. So now, we are going to look at the failure curves of software and hardware. Let's look at the hardware failure curve. This graph presents the typical failure curve of a hardware production line. We call this as bathtub curve. High failure rate is discovered at first time of production due to trial and errors. It is important to come up with highly effective, less defective stable design to start the actual manufacturing process. So then, it could make the manufacturing at steady level where the lowest failure rate is achieved. As time passes, there comes a time technology advancement would not be able to go along with the manufacturing. That's why floppy disks are not manufactured these days. It's wear out. On the other hand, for software, it is difficult to carry on the work with stable designs. As the time goes by, the customer expects the software would be changed for their needs because software is just a piece of written code. As changes are made, it is likely that errors will be introduced, causing the failure rate curve to spike as shown in the actual curve. Before the curve can return to the original steady state failure rate, Another change is requested, causing the curve to spike again. Slowly, the minimum failure rate level began to rise. We call it as deteriorate. So, software doesn't wear out as hardware, but deteriorate due to change. Good. Now we know the significance between hardware and software. Therefore, now we can move into software quality. Attributes of good software. There are few notable models, and we selected McCall's classification introduced by Jim McCall et al. McCall had classified the qualities as qualities for product operation, product revision, and product transition. Let's look at it in much detail. In his classification for product operation category, it has basic operational characteristics, or else we can say qualities what user expects. Qualities that users really valued in the system to perform day-to-day activities. Qualities are correctness, reliability, usability, integrity, and efficiency. The next category, product revision category, measures the system's ability to change. These include maintainability, flexibility, and testability. These are the qualities that current developers and future developers would perceive beneficial. Users would not care them, but the developers would find them more beneficial. Last category is product transition. These qualities measures the adaptability to new environments. Interoperability, reusability, and portability are the qualities it needed to measure. Both the users and developers valued them. Right. That's all about McCall's classification. So with this episode, we learned a little bit about software qualities and how different people perceive them in what aspects. In another episode, we will discuss what each quality attribute actually means in much detail. So thank you for listening. Hope to see you again in the next lecture for Software Engineering Professional Practice. With that episode, we will learn why developing software is an engineering profession. What are the ethics and moral obligations software engineers should have? See you next time. Goodbye. Lesson content prepared and delivered by Upeka Vandibona. This video brought to you by edupediaworld.com. To watch more, visit our website. Thank you.